Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Anthony, for this opportunity. Thank you all for having us here today. I want to tell you something a little bit about Marco Rubio. You know, when he left as Speaker of the House, the last day of Speaker, he gave a speech, his farewell speech. And in that speech, he talked about something that was unprecedented, had never been done before. He talked about the love of God, the grace of God, the role of Jesus Christ in his life. And I tell you, all of the, never been done before, but all of the liberals and the humanists and the agnostics and the atheists up in the rafters and the press corps and the universities and the editorial boards, their jaws dropped. They couldn't believe it. Flies were going in and out of their mouths that someone had spoken on the floor of the House of Representatives about God. But it happened, and I'll tell you why. As many of you know, Marco Rubio is a father of four. I was there for the birth of all four of those children. I wasn't in the room, but Jeanette would not have allowed that. But I was outside in the waiting room. If you want someone in the U.S. Senate that will stand up for family and for marriage and for prayer in school, then I ask you right now, stand up for the next United States Senator from Florida, Marco Rubio.
Thank you, David, for that introduction. Boy, am I glad we finished breakfast before he described all these things I did with the kids. Thank you. Thank you to Christian Family Coalition. I appreciate very much your invitation for being here, and I appreciate you putting this event together. I want to also acknowledge the other candidates that are here. The campaigns can be difficult, and campaigns can get hard, and they can get long. And I want to tell you that we should all appreciate the people who are willing to offer themselves to run for public service. But today I want to focus on an issue that's always important, and that issue is the sanctity of life. I think this is an appropriate forum to do it. I brought this with me because it talks so much about the purpose of this organization and an issue that I hope unites us all as Americans and as Christians. Christian Family Coalition is the only national pro-life, pro-family organization founded by a minority, Hispanic, American, and a lay person. Pro-life. Let's talk about what that issue means today. Let's talk about what it means from the beginning of our country. Our nation, its very inception, was based on a Declaration of Independence that recognized that every single human being has unalienable rights that come from their Creator. Among those rights are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And think about how the Declaration was written. Life was first. And you know why? Because without life, there is no liberty. And without life, you cannot pursue happiness. That is the foundations of our nation. And from that has emerged the greatest society in all of human history. But in 1973, the Supreme Court of the United States made a ruling. It's a case called Roe v. Wade. Roe v. Wade said that in America, there is a constitutional right to have an abortion. Basically what it says is that in America, the only people who do not have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness are those who have not yet been born. And the results have been horrifying. 50 million abortions since 1973. 1 million unborn children were aborted just last year. Now here's why I'm pointing this out to you. We live in a time where people love to ascribe labels to themselves. And it's easy in politics to just have a label ascribed to you. But here's the bottom line. If you do not believe that Roe v. Wade should be overturned, you are not pro-life. If you don't understand that that is the consequential, singular event that has created this catastrophe in America, you are not pro-life. And I say this to you understanding full well what that means. I know what this speech here today means. I know this is the receptive audience of this message. But polls tell us that half the American people disagree with me on this issue. I know that there are people out there today, maybe even this audience, who agree with me on every other issue. But because of my position on this one, will not vote for me. I understand the political difficulties of it. I also understand it's a topic that makes people uncomfortable. This is not about imposing a view on anybody. This is about what influence should faith have on your life. And if you're in politics, what influence should it have on your job? For Christians, the answer to that question is not hard. It's right in the gospel. It says, whatever you do, do everything for the glory of God.
I believe this man about to introduce me is a man that